Wave.com.
Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow. Dow Industrials right now trading up 197. NASDAQ up 84. S&P's up 17.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Tuesday at 30 past the hour. Don't forget, folks, Basil has an outstanding show here every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, The Opening Call. Very easy to get the opening call, folks. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right under featured content, the opening call. You just hit subscribe. You can get the opening call for 1 month for $128. You can get it for 6 months for $595, which is a savings of $173 or 22%. You can get it for a year for $995, which is a savings of $541 or 35%. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
Good, man. I heard it's hot in Boston.
It is hot, but better hot than cold.
Yeah. Hey, it's the summer, right?
Absolutely, yes.
So, what are we going to look at here? Did you just hear, Jason, that those five stocks are 21% of the S&P 500?
I was listening to that.
S&P 500. Okay.
Well, we also have to realize that there are even smaller companies in the United States that have total gross that is far more than the gross product of many countries, most countries, in fact.
Oh, no, I get that. But five stocks out of 500 stocks would be 20%.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
That definitely is a concentration. I'm going to show you something very interesting here because, as I've told you before, we've been long the dollar for subscribers to my opening call, and we've been long the Dow, that is, from in the diamonds themselves from 210, and the diamonds right now are trading at 261. So it's been, we've held that.
Congratulations, that's awesome.
Thank you. Yeah. So I'm going to try to, for an index to be able to get that percentage on an index, this is not 2-1 or 3, this is 1-1. So it's just, that's quite good. We're really quite pleased with that. Now, what's really interesting is have a look at this chart on the left. I've got the daily Dow, in the middle, I've got the weekly, on the right, I've got the monthly chart. If you look at the daily chart, you'll see that there was a gap up in the Dow at that was on the 5th of June, going to 27,338. The low was 26,836. Then there was a higher high, and that was a recovery high, 27,580, and a turnaround. And as you know, I'm always looking for those peak D, the fourth highest peak is where we start to raise our foot off the accelerator, hover over the break, because that's where other things can happen. You can see right here in the weekly chart at 29,568, and in February, that's where that was a weekly peak. Look at that sharp 39% drop. Same thing in the monthly. So I'm always respectful of that. But now look at this. So there are four candles above this low of 26,836. And then, you remember that very sharp decline that that was on the 11th, almost 2,000 points in the Dow. Gap down. And that becomes very important because this is in technical terms called an island reversal. Now we often get island reversals, but usually not a recovery high pulling back and then not going back to cover that gap. So that says there are two patterns that I'm looking at. There are always two fighting patterns, one positive and one negative. In this particular instance, I'm looking at, I drew this pattern in a little while back for subscribers to see that this is called the H pattern, called the dreaded H, because if it takes out the left side low, it can go quite a bit lower. So here we are, we're forming the H, and then all of a sudden it holds the 200 period moving average, and we're stuck in this range. Here's the other pattern. I'll just drag this across here to show it. And the reason why I want to show it, because it's happening in a lot of stocks, and we're going to be having in my show tomorrow, I'm going to show the how these leading stocks are starting to make patterns like this. So there's a pattern that it looks like an axe with a handle and a blade that opens out. Basically, it's an expanding cone that has lower highs and much lower lows. And then all of a sudden, it forms a bottom. It turns around, makes either a V-shaped pattern or a cup formation. And if it breaks that trend line, you can have a one-to-one to the upside. So with that in mind, look what's happened here. We've gone, he has this declining line, and we've bumped into it two times.
We just
haven't been able to break out. The MACD is negative. The stochastic's only at 42%. On balance, volume is not great. But at the same time, this beautiful indicator, this nine-period this green 9-period exponential moving average is still above the black 14-period moving average. And for some reason, I've shown you this a lot over the years, when the price remains above that and when the green remains above the black, you can see a pullback, but as long as it holds, you're going to get a spring back above it. So it says to me that we've got very clear parameters. 26,611 was the high that was made on the 16th. We need to go above that, and that says, hey, now we're going to fill in the gap. And if we break down below yesterday's low, which was right on the 200-period moving average, 25,600, you can expect we're going to make the HM will go down. So those are the parameters we're looking at. Weekly chart still looks very bullish. Remember, I had this stalk leg, body, neck, and the B came down. Usually after the B concludes, there's a nice bounce, and that's kind of what we're getting. And the monthly chart is still looking pretty good. So parameters are clear. As I say, we've raised our foot off the accelerator a little bit because there's a lot going on. We've had some real nice gains. One of our stocks, CRS, which I've mentioned a couple of times, Cirrus Core, they do global blood transfusion. They have components for that. And look at this monthly chart, very strong. Weekly chart, leg B. Technicals are very strong, and it's trying to test the 685. We're up about 52% on this stock. It looks good. And in fact, that's one of the things we're looking at here. If you look at the different sectors, it's sector related. And look how nicely the small cap biotech, some of them have been absolutely fantastic, and this is in that category. And just talking about patterns, I mentioned to subscribers over the weekend, I like the way that the gold is, although we didn't get into the gold, I love this. There's this falling axe formation. Look how it broke out, and this green line right here, I call it a Chapman Wave 1-to-1 expansion. And I was doing this on my show the other day to say, if gold, this is a continuous contract, breaks this particular resistance, you could get a 1-to-1 expansion. And very conservatively, I take it from the bottom here, and that it's exactly at that 1-to-1. But if it continues rallying, and the whole thing about the parallel line is, look, it has exactly the same angle. That's the whole thing about this. It's not just 1-to-1. It has the same a velocity to the upside, and that corresponds to the weakness. And we are still long gold, the dollar from 90 back in 2018 in April. But he has that H pattern, so I'm watching this really closely, because if it does form that H pattern, it takes out 95.72. Let's say 95. That's not good. And there's the same parallel pattern that we were looking at in the dollar to give you the expansion to the downside.
Yeah.
So it's there now. So I'm watching this very closely. So I think it doesn't work exactly that way, but very often the direction, not the price percentage movement, the direction, when the dollar goes one way, gold goes the other. So I'm watching this very closely.
It's a heck of a ride, man. No doubt about it. No doubt about it.
It is, absolutely.
Folks, come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see the opening call right under the featured content. You just hit subscribe. You can get it for a month, 6 months, a year. Basil has a huge amount of archives that are right in there, folks. You want to understand how the market moves. Bottom line, you get it all. 30-day money-back guarantee. Basil, you have a great one, safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.
You too, Tom. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.